नमस्कार दोस्तों, मैं हूं आपका होस्ट हीरा लाल।
वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स फॉर द गोवा विजिट। होप यू हैव वॉच्ड माय अदर वीडियोस ऑन गोवा विजिट। सो फ्रेंड्स, प्लीज टेक केयर। We have left from Kolwa to visit a museum on the village lifestyle of old Goa. It will take nearly half an hour reaching there. The museum or exhibition on ancestral village Goa is situated in the small village of Lotolim, which is about 10 kilometers from Margao or Kolwa and 25 kilometers from Panaji. The museum is also known as Big Foot. It is privately run by an artist called Mendra Joselino Arauzo Alvarez, something like Nek Chand of Chandigarh, who has created Rock Garden. What one should check out: the entryway and foyer have been designed to look like the gates of a castle, and the foyer of an old-fashioned mansion, gracious and welcoming. The open-air museum recreates Goan rural life as it was 100 years ago. The museum is open on all days from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. and has a small entry fee. At ancestral Goa, one is accompanied by a guide who explains the exhibits. Legend has it that Goa was created by an arrow shot by Lord Parshurama, and his statue taking aim with his bow is one of the first sights within the compound.
So according to Hindu mythology, he is the creator of Goa.
The land of Goa is a melting pot of cultures and traditions and is one of the best examples of communal harmony, with various cultures living in peace with each other and their surrounding ecosystem.
So the owner of this house was an advocate. His name is Salvador Irvino Francisco Araujo Alvarez. He used to solve the cases, and he used to make two copies out of it. One he used to keep with him, and another he used to send to Panjim as a record. Soldier Rahul the Vega and the two children with a photo are the sixth generation of this family. They live in Margao. His father is maintaining this house at present. That's the reason for it. It's a washed basin. Earlier there were no soaps, so they used to use rita, it's a kind of fruit. Nowadays they use in making herbal shampoos. There's an emergency commode. They used to wear this clothes for the mask, and this is chandelier brought from Belgium. In a separate glass, they used to put half water, half coconut oil, and with a cotton pin, they used to light it. So, palanquin. They used to use a palanquin like an ambulance. If anybody is sick, they used to carry it. The safety. There used to be a gang of robbers named Rade, the very kind-hearted and lovable robbers. Before they used to come to rob the house, they used to inform 5 in advance. We will come so and so time, so and so day, please give me something outside. By getting the message from the bigger hole, the smaller hole they used to put guns to shoot them. And they used to keep something outside like jewelry or money. Whatever they get outside, they used to take. If they are not satisfied, they used to enter the house and they will be shooting like this. soda bottle and these are soda bottles from Bombay London. This is a mini bar. This is a wine barrel. They used to import wine from Portugal. These are the Garrafón. It is used to store cashew feni, Goa's famous liquor.
Taverna, a small village bar and liquor store still seen everywhere today. Art gallery. The art gallery is a forum for the display of traditional and modernist Goan artists and has played host to a number of events and art shows. Casa de Dona Maria, the traditional landlord's house in Goa with tiled roof and altar room. The house was modeled on Portuguese architectural styles with a hint of Goan decor thrown in.
Sadri Mountain shot an arrow which fell in the Arabian Sea, which is holy made up of coconut leaves.
Coastal treasure. The coastline of Goa was vital on the state's trade and commerce. Traditional occupations included fishing and coconut husking, which are also depicted here.
Here is the fisherman's hut, holy mud of coconut tree. Over bell the boat, anchor stop the boat.
Rural trade of those who did not make their living off the sea made it growing rice the staple food of Goa. The typical village house has been constructed here in miniature style. Brewing nectar, ambrosia, perhaps one of the most famous occupations of Goa, is the cultivation of cashew nuts, both for nuts themselves and for the fanny, which is brewed from the fruit.
देखिए फर्स्ट ये मॉडल काजू का पेड़, किसी पेड़ में लाल किसी पेड़ में येलो, जब पक गया बी तोड़ के टोकरी में रखेगी, फल खड्डे में उड़ाएगी। ये इसमें ऑटोमेटिक 3 दिन पर बड़ा हंडी रखा है, ये हंडी का आधा हंडी दिया हवा बंद करने के लिए।
सॉल्ट पैंस, ट्रेडिशनल गोवा सॉल्ट पैंस where river and sea water was collected and allowed to evaporate, leaving behind unprocessed salt. Fount of life, the Boca da Vaca or cow's mouth, is a spring like many which are seen in traditional villages, often believed to have medicinal properties. Hinterland ethics. Besides farming and fishing, there were craftsmen who piled their trade in Goa, like cobblers and potters, etc.
और ये सुतार यहाँ पर दिखाई कैसी औरत लोग को जमाने में पर्दे के पीछे रहे।
These sites found on the edge of the village were thanksgiving shrines for safe journey through the forested hinterlands where traveling had to be done on foot. Rural trade trends. The rural marketplaces were not only a place to buy your groceries, but also a meeting place where gossip and the news of the day were exchanged over vegetables, meat and fish. The traditional Hindu homes of Goa, complete with the tulsi plant out in the front, its decorated clay pot, a symbol of purity and good health. Legend of the Bigfoot. A wealthy landowner used to generously give of his own monies to the less fortunate. However, unscrupulous people took advantage of his good nature and fleeced him of all his worldly goods. Seeing this generosity of spirits, the gods granted him a boon. The men, being humble and pure, asked only for a small place to pray. The gods gave him a hot rock where he could stand on one foot and pray. The man used this rock day and night until the gods, impressed with his devotion, took him up to heaven, leaving behind his footprint on the rock with the legend that all those of pure heart would be blessed with luck. Saint Mirabai sculpture. This is the longest laterite sculpture in India and depicts Saint Mirabai strumming her tambori. It shows influences of the famous Gandhara school of art. The verdant patio. Many of the traditionally grown fruits and vegetables of Goa have long since been replaced with high yield varieties. This place attempts to preserve the traditional produce. The Bigfoot dance floor, shaped like a large foot. This dance floor has been created to be versatile venue with the ability to host a variety of functions like weddings, anniversaries, seminars, dances, etc. Feathered friends, Goa is home to more than 450 species of birds and butterflies. The verdant patio. Many of the traditionally grown fruits and vegetables of Goa have long since been replaced with high yield varieties. This place attempts to preserve the traditional produce. The rubber plantation. This depicts the traditional methods of tapping rubber trees as well as making of sheets of rubber. It also makes a great place to relax in the shade of the rubber plants. The artisan habitat, a place where artists and artisans are provided with eco-friendly accommodation and a chance to give their creativity free rein. Also, one can purchase souvenirs on the way out from the handicraft center.
Hi. यहाँ पे एक पोल रखा है जिसमें से आपको तेल डालना है. आप कोई भी तेल खाम में ले सकते हैं. दिए जलाने के लिए को सीधा करना है. तेल की एक बूंद बाहर नहीं आएगी. फिर यहाँ से कॉटन विक डाल के दिया जलाना है. ये डिफरेंट टाइप्स के हैंगिंग हैं और डिफरेंट रिलीजियस फिगर्स हैं जैसे गणेश.
The entire complex has been built with the idea of allowing people a glimpse into the lives of everyday people from Goa's rich history. Populated mostly by statues which depicts the various traditional activities of Goan villagers, this is both a fun and educational experience.